Then drop silence was, which was interrupted by chirping of the birds. Choo, choo, choo. And I was in the middle of the road, alone. There were houses by the side of the road, deserted. Some people say silence is golden, but there was no ounce of golden in this apartment. I was a little scared. And as that thought passed my mind, the wind started howling suddenly. And I heard a soft roar. The roar that was growing louder and louder as the time went. And I looked behind. And what do I see? I see a huge wave coming right in front of me. And before I could think about anything, I was totally, completely engulfed by the wave. And I was thrashing my arms wildly trying to get control, but guess what? It's a big wave. There was nothing I could do. And at that point in time, the moments of my life till now flashed right before my eyes. And then, all of a sudden, the wave started subsiding. The moments of my life slowed down. And as the flood of the thoughts that completely engulfed me was sudden, so was the disappearance of it. And I stopped at an interesting point in my life when I was 15 years old. I was about 15 years old. I was in 8th grade. And I loved to sing. When I was singing, I was in a different part of the world. I was happy. And I was pretty good too. I started taking singing lessons. But that happiness was short-lived because something happened at that point in time. My voice cracked, you know, becoming from a boy to a man. And that beautiful voice which I loved was no longer anymore. I was so stunned by it that I made a decision that I am never ever going to sing again. And so it was. Till now, I never ever sung. 23 years of my life passed by. The feeling of happiness which I got from singing, I never did. And I was wondering why this thought came right now. Singing is not even on my list of priorities right now. I have so many other things I want to do, but not singing. I don't want to go to American Idol. Why? And then it dawned on me, as I looked behind, the pleasure I got when I sang, I missed having it right now in my life. I realized that there was a part of me I'd locked forever. And I decided that this was the right time for me to open that up, to unlock that, and to experience a new self for myself. And so I decided I am going to sing. But after that decision, I didn't sing. It took me about 2 weeks. And then I said, you know what, let's give it a shot. And I tried to sing. I was off key, and at a high note, my voice broke down completely. And I'm like, wow, in the past 23 years, I've changed so much that I can't even really sing now. What do I do? Various phrases came into my mind. You know, you're spreading yourself too thin. You're trying to do too many things. Take it one step at a time. Focus on the important things. Focus on the big stones in your life. And there was another phrase that came to my mind. You can do anything you want, but not everything. And I was like, yeah, probably I should just give up and say, you know what, singing is not for me anymore. And I did that. I was not complete with it, as you can see, but I did it because there were more important things for me to do. But as it so happens, a couple of days later, I was driving to school with my 5-year-old daughter, just sitting in the back, and we heard a song. That Line by Miley Cyrus. Anybody heard it?
Mm-hmm.
No?
Yes.
And things changed for me. I can almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming. There's a voice inside my head says, you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. Our faith is shaking. But I gotta keep trying. Gotta keep my head held high. Sorry, I went off key, but that's what it really felt good. It feels good now. It feels good that I can sing. A little bit more practice, I'll get better. But I can sing. But what feels good is that now I have unlocked and accessed a portion of me that had blocked myself for life. And why is that important? When you lock yourself, a portion of it, you harden yourself. When you harden yourself, you're not truly connected with yourself. If you're not truly connected with yourself, how? How in this world are you going to connect with others? Your family, your friend, those masters, people in your life. How are you going to be able to fully experience the life that you have been given the privilege to live? How? So I learned three things from my failure. One, whenever things get confusing, listen to your heart. Your spirit, your true self. Two, always believe in yourself. Don't give up. Don't ever give up. And three, life is full of obstacles. You will win some, you will lose some. I didn't sing well today. But finally, it's the journey, it's the climb. And the journey with you being connected with yourself is way more important than you'll ever find anything in your life to be. So folks, take a look at your lives, your past, the passions that you had that you gave up, and pursue them. Because this is what holds the key to your fully living.